radio.com, the positive side of broadcasting. Good evening once again, and welcome to this very special edition of Heal the Cause with Dr. Catherine Saltzman.
Thank you, Bill, and welcome everyone to the most important topic Heal the Cause has ever broadcast. I'm Dr. Catherine Saltzman, and I'm glad you're with us tonight because we have someone who's going to talk to you about a public health epidemic that will probably surprise you and make you want to tell others. What makes a topic important? When the message has the potential to stop massive suffering and save thousands of lives. In this case, we're talking about not saving tens of thousands of lives, but hundreds of thousands of lives. My friends, we are on the verge of a public health epidemic of nightmare proportions, unlike anything we have ever seen in history. My guest, Dr. George Carlo, is bringing this important message to the world, and he is being sought out by the media. Dr. Carlo has been on 2020, 60 Minutes, World News Tonight, CBS News with Dan Rather, and The Today Show. He's also appeared on CNN, Fox News, MSNBC. It goes on and on. And if that's not enough, in July, a documentary film of his work will be released in major theaters. He's well qualified to deliver this public health threat message. He is a medical researcher, an epidemiologist in the field for 25 years. He has a PhD in pathology. He's an attorney, and he is the author of Cell Phones, Invisible Hazards of the Wireless Age. Those of you who listen to this show regularly know that Jeffrey and I dedicated an entire show to describing Dr. Carlo's journey from wireless researcher to industry whistleblower. Those of you who have my book, 20 Do's and Don'ts to Transform Your Health, which I published in 2002, may remember that one of the don'ts is don't overuse a cell phone. In that chapter, I talked about Dr. Carlo's $28.5 million research project on cell phone safety and the resulting evidence showing that radio frequency radiation creates what's called micronuclei in human blood cells. That's a type of genetic damage known to be a diagnostic marker for cancer. Since 2002, cell phone use has increased. Their watts per kilogram have increased, and the age of cell phone users has broadened into teenagers and, sad to say, even small children. I warned in my book that children's skulls are penetrated deeply by the energy emitted from cell phones. If you're new to this topic, the first thing I want to do is reassure you that neither Dr. Carlo nor myself are here to ask you to give up your cell phone. We recognize that it's become an important tool in business, convenience, and personal safety. Solutions do exist, and we will talk about that. But the first thing is that it's vital that you and every person you care about understand the gravity of the situation as it exists today in terms of the wireless industry cover-up of the serious dangers of cell phone use. Achieve Radio, in recognizing the importance of this subject, has kindly given Dr. Carlo an hour and a half to tell his story and educate us on the reality of cell phone use. And as you may know, this broadcast will remain in the Achieve Radio archives, so you can send your friends here to listen anytime from anywhere in the world. I guarantee you will want to do that after hearing his story. So at this time, I want to welcome you, Dr. Carlo, to Heal the Cause. Achieve Radio is honored to have you with us.
Thank you, Dr. Catherine. It's a pleasure to be here.
Let me start by saying that sometimes finding and healing the cause of unhappiness, poor health, or disease is very difficult and can become a lifelong quest in itself. But in this case, we can be very clear about the cause of certain devastating illnesses and cancers that are increasing in alarming proportions. That cause is cell phone use. The country got their first big exposure to it on Larry King Live in 1992. Dr. Carlo, can you start by telling us what happened on that show?
Well, back in those days, Catherine, we had about 15 million Americans using cell phones. And in 1991, a woman passed away from a brain tumor, and her husband had bought her a cell phone during her pregnancy so that he would be able to reach her on a regular basis. She died of the brain tumor, and she and her husband attributed, along with her physician, the development of the brain tumor to her cell phone use. And the doctor was asked to appear on Larry King Live to talk about the medical case, and there was a subsequent lawsuit also filed with regard to that case. Now, when this was presented on Larry King Live, the doctor brought in an X-ray of where the tumor was located, and then he superimposed a cell phone over the site of the tumor, and the tumor was exactly where the cell phone antenna was.
That is just astonishing. And tell me what happened after that.
Well, up until that time, no one had really made a link between cell phone use and brain cancer. And in fact, cell phone, which is a radiation-emitting device, had been exempted from any regulatory testing prior to going into the marketplace. And this dates back to 1984. So that the cell phone, which should have been tested prior to going into market, had not been tested. And the reason was because it operated at very low power, and the scientific understanding at the time was that if you had a low power signal, it could not cause any tissue damage or harm. So that the allegation, if you will, in 1993 that the cell phone could be the cause of this brain cancer was something that was brand new. Now, the next day after the Larry King Live show, the cell phone industry, the Trade Association for the Manufacturers of Cell Phones,